I am Nico D. First of all, I've got 1,000 subscribers on my channel, so thank you all for that. I'm very happy with that. So today we are going to compare four different SBCs with each other. So to begin with, the NanoPi M4 and the RockPi 4B. Both are very much alike. They both have got the same SoC, so the RK3399. So they perform the same. The only difference is this one has got an NVMe slot over here, so it can't have an NVMe head. And this one has got PCI Express over GPIOs, but it also can fit an NVMe head or a USB 3 head or a SATA head. So I love these boards. This one I use as a desktop computer. It has replaced my PC. I love it. It just does great. It has got GPU drivers and VPU drivers for Linux. So that's great. The only thing I don't like about the RockPi 4B is that you have to remove the heatsink to be able to reach the eMMC. That's the only thing I don't like about it, but both are great boards. Then next is the Oldroid N2 and the CADAS VIM3. So both also have got very much alike SoCs, but this one has got the Amlogic S922X, while this one has got the Amlogic A311D. The only difference in those is this one has got an NPU, so a neural processing unit on board, and the big cores A73 are clocked to 2.2 GHz, while here they are clocked to 1.8 GHz. Otherwise the SoCs are the same. Of course the designs are very different. The Oldroid N2 doesn't have Wi-Fi. It's the only one that doesn't have Wi-Fi on board, but it does have a great heatsink. You do not need to use a fan with this, so that's great. The CADAS VIM3 also has got great characteristics. It performs amazingly and it doesn't consume a lot, so it is great to use as a laptop. I use this one as a laptop. The Oldroid N2 is for me a gaming PC, so I use this one only to play games and also to watch 4K videos. So they all have got different characteristics, so I'm gonna compare the specs. I'm gonna compare the performance of all four the boards. I'm gonna show you the data transfer speeds for all four the boards. So here we go! So the NanoPi M4 has got the RK3399 with 2x A72 at 1.8 GHz, can be overclocked to 2 GHz, and 4x A53 at 1.4 GHz, which can be clocked to 1.5 GHz. There's a version with 2 GB of RAM and one with 4 GB of RAM, DDR3. There's now also the M4 version 2 with LPDDR4 4 GB only. So this has got gigabit Ethernet and it has got Wi-Fi on board and Bluetooth 4.1. The M4 has got 4 USB 3 ports over 2 USB 3 controllers. So the left two ports have got one USB 3 controller and the right two ports have got one USB controller too. So there's an SD card slot. There's an eMMC socket with eMMC modules up to 64 GB. There is the PCI Express GPIO header for the NVMe head or the SATA head or the USB 3 head. So this has got a 3.5 mm audio jack and also audio over HDMI. And it is powered with USB Type-C, only 5 volts. The RockPi 4 has got exactly the same SoC as the NanoPi M4. It has got 2 GB or 4 GB LPDDR4 RAM, Gigabit Ethernet Wi-Fi on board and Bluetooth 5.0. It has got 2 USB 3 ports, each have got their own controller and 2 USB 2 ports. So microSD slots, eMMC socket up to 128 GB. So this is the same eMMC socket as for the Oldroids. So this is good that it is compatible with other boards. So it has got an NVMe connector, 3.5 mm audio jack and audio over HDMI. And it is powered with USB Type-C, but it can be powered up to 20 volts. The Oldroid N2 has got the Amlogic S922X with 4 big cores A73 at 1.8 GHz, can be overclocked to 2 GHz, and 2 small cores A53 at 1.9 GHz. So there's also 2 GB or 4 GB versions DDR4. It has got gigabit Ethernet, but there is no Wi-Fi or Bluetooth on board. There are 4 USB 3 ports, but there's only one USB 3 controller. So all 4 ports go over one USB 3 controller. There's also a micro USB OTG port. So micro SD slots, eMMC socket up to 128 GB. There is no NVMe SATA or PCI Express. So there's a 3.5 mm audio jack and also audio over HDMI. And it is powered with a barrel jack at 12 volts. And the CADAS FIM3 has got the Amlogic A311D with 4x A73 at 2.2 GHz and 2x A53 at 1.9 GHz. So it's got the Mali-G52 GPU and an NPU. So there's a 2GB version or 4GB LPDDR4. It's got gigabit Ethernet and Wi-Fi on board and Bluetooth 5.0. There's one USB 3 port and one USB 2 port. There's a micro SD slot, an eMMC module on board of 16GB or 32GB. There is an NVMe slot, but this goes over the USB 3 port, so you have to disable the USB 3 port for that. There is audio over HDMI only, and it is powered with USB Type-C up to 20 volts. And now MIPI CSI and DSI, so for the NanoPi M4, both MIPI ports can be used as MIPI CSI, 4-lane, or you can use one port for the display and one port for the camera. The ROGPi has got one 2-lane MIPI CSI and one 2-lane MIPI DSI. These are compatible with the Raspberry Pi, so this is something good for the ROGPi. The Android N2 doesn't have this. And the CADAS FIM3 has got one 4-lane MIPI CSI and one 4-lane MIPI DSI. Now the Nico D Blender benchmark. So this is all done in Armbian Bionic at a default clock speed. So the NanoPi M4 done it in 22 minutes and 18 seconds. And the ROGPi 4 did it in 22 minutes and 19 seconds. So it's the same as the NanoPi M4. The Oldroid N2 did it in 14 minutes and 19 seconds, so this is quite a bit faster than the RK3399s. And then the CADAS FIM3 did it in 11 minutes and 28 seconds. So this is almost twice as fast as the RK3399s. So the CADAS FIM3 really has an incredible CPU. Now the single core benchmarks with 7-zip. So the small cores of the NanoPi M4 clocked at 1.4 GHz got 1249 and the big cores clocked at 1.8 GHz got 1813. So for the ROGPi 4 these cores are almost exactly the same. Then the Oldroid N2, its small cores clocked at 1.9 GHz got 1629 and the big cores clocked at 1.8 GHz got 1891. Here you see the difference between an A72 core and an A73 core clocked at the same clock speeds. The A73 performs a little bit better, but it is marginal. Then the CADAS FIM3, the small cores also clocked at 1.9 GHz, 1613, and the big cores 2349. So the CADAS FIM3 shines at its single core performance. Do note that the RK3399s can be clocked to 2 GHz, then they get 2000 for their big cores, and also the Oldroid N2 can be clocked to 2 GHz. It also gets a little bit higher than 2000. Now the transfer speeds. So the NanoPi M4 has got the fastest SD card reader, so 68 MB per second reads and 20 MB per second writes. The USB 3 is around 400 MB per second. The NVMe reaches 637 MB per second reads and 400 MB per second writes. This is around 700 MB per second for 2.5 GB and then it goes down to 300 MB per second. So the eMMC, a 32 GB module, 173 MB per second reads and 111 MB per second writes. So for the ROGPi 4, the SD card is a lot slower, so 23 MB per second reads and 14 MB per second writes. The USB 3 performs great, so 400 megabytes per second. The NVMe performs even better than on the NanoPi M4, so 730 megabytes per second read, and the write speed is even higher, 745 megabytes per second. Then the eMMC module. This is the module I've gotten from RockPi. So this is a 16 gigabyte module, but it is blazing fast. So the read speed is 214 megabytes per second and the write speed is 165 megabytes per second. That's the fastest eMMC that I've got. Then the Oldroid N2, the SD card reader is okay, so 61 megabytes per second read and only 14 megabytes per second write. The USB 3 performs bad for me, so it's only 230 megabytes per second reads and 240 megabytes per second writes. I do not know why this performs this bad. It is the same SSD with the same USB 3 SATA adapter, and the eMMC module that I'm using is 32 gigabytes, and the read speed is 151 megabytes per second, and the write speed is 125 megabytes per second. So the Oldroid N2 does really bad in transfer speeds. So for a NAS, there are better boards than the Oldroid N2, but of course you can use it for that. Then the CADASFIM 3, the SD card reader is also slow, so 22 megabytes per second read and 10 megabytes per second write. The SSD over USB 3, 286 megabytes per second read and 380 megabytes per second write. Then the NVMe is over the USB 3, so this will be at USB 3 speeds, so not more than 400 megabytes per second. And then the onboard eMMC module is 165 megabytes per second read and 60 megabytes per second write. This is the 16 gigabyte module. Maybe the 32 gigabyte module of the Pro is faster. So that's it for today. As you could see, the Amlogic boards are a lot more powerful than the RK3399 boards, but they lack in transfer speeds. There's only one lane USB 3, and this is really a limit. It is best to use the eMMC on the Oldroid N2, so you don't saturate the USB 3, then you can connect an external hard drive. But if you do it all over the USB 3, then it gets saturated really quickly. The Oldroid N2 really is great for gaming and to watch 4K video, but in Linux it really lacks. There are no X11 drivers for it and no GPU drivers for now, so gaming on it in Linux is very hard or impossible. But there are a lot of images like Batocera and EmuElec to play games, and also CoreElec to watch movies at 4K. For the CADASFIM 3 this is the same, but of course it has got a little bit more CPU power. Only the RK3399s have VPU drivers, so I can watch with a display resolution of 1440p to 1080p videos in YouTube, and even 4K videos with the Rockchip player. So for an NAS, I would advise one of the RK3399 boards. If you like Android and if you like emulation, then the Oldroid N2 is great for you. The CADASFIM 3 is great when you need a lot of CPU power. So that's it for today. I hope you liked my video. Thank you all for watching. Please subscribe to my channel. See you all later. Bye.